Hey everyone, the Polyhaven Asset Browser add-on was just released for Blender. Polyhaven is a giant library of 3D assets created by artists from around the world and free for anyone to use, even commercially and without attribution. The Polyhaven add-on brings all of these assets right into Blender's asset browser so we can just drag and drop them into our scene. It is great, but there's one thing you need to know before you start using it. So let's jump into this review slash tutorial. Polyhaven was originally three separate sites, HDRI Haven, Texture Haven, and 3D Model Haven. They've now combined into Polyhaven. The site is essentially a nonprofit from South Africa, committed to providing assets for 3D artists and game developers for free and with CC0 licenses. They have over 1,000 assets, and new ones are generally added each week. While all of the assets on Polyhaven are completely free, the add-on is not. It currently costs $30 on Blender Market, but it helps support a site that gives us a lot of free stuff. All future updates are included with the one-time purchase. It downloads pretty much just like any other add-on. You get a zip file, go to the add-on section in the preferences, choose install. Navigate to the zip file, but don't unzip it, choose it, install it, and then find Polyhaven Asset Browser in our list of add-ons. Check the box to activate it. Unlike most add-ons, we will need to expand the arrow on the left and configure another setting. We can see a warning that says no asset library named Polyhaven. We need to set one up, but it's really easy. Move over to the File Paths tab and go down to the bottom. Press the plus icon to add a new library path for the Blender asset browser. I recommend creating a new and completely empty file folder to store the assets from Polyhaven. Select the folder and make sure the library is named Polyhaven. If we go back to our add-on settings, we see the warning is fixed. Now, let's see how to use the Polyhaven Asset Library add-on. We will need to open an asset browser editor in Blender. I'll pull this up and change the editor to an asset browser. Change from current file and choose the newly added Polyhaven library. By the way, if you're unfamiliar with Blender's asset browser, I have a complete and updated guide to it at brandonsdrawings.com/asset browser. With the Polyhaven library selected, we don't see any assets because we haven't imported any yet. But we do see this new button called Fetch Assets. If we click this, it will import every single asset from Polyhaven into the folder we set up for our library path. As of this video, that's just over 1,000 assets consisting of HDRIs, materials, and 3D models. Under the arrow, we can choose to import only the type of assets we want. If we were only interested in the models, for example, we could fetch only those. I chose to import these individually, just because I wasn't sure how big the import would be, how much space the assets would take up, or how long it would take. Each category took about a minute to download. Not bad. When all 1,000 plus assets were downloaded, they totaled about 3.5 gigabytes on my hard drive. So this is important. Make sure you have enough space on your hard drive to store those assets, or at least the categories you're choosing to import. We can always remove assets we don't want later, but the import will bring in all the assets of the selected type. So let's fast forward to after we import the assets. They all appear in the asset browser, and almost all of them have perfect preview images, which is really nice. When I originally imported all the assets, there were no catalogs set up, and that was going to be a big complaint of mine. Then when I opened Blender the next time, the catalogs were all there. I'm not sure if that was an update or if it just took some time, but I did not set these up manually. All of the assets were well organized and easy to navigate. To bring assets into our scene, we simply drag and drop them into the 3D viewport. If it's a 3D object, we can drop it right on top of where we want it to go. If it's a material, we drag it onto the object we want it applied to. If it's an HDRI, dragging it into our scene will add it to our world settings and overwrite whatever we had before. It's super easy to use. The only issue is we need to have the space to store all of the assets. Anytime a new asset is added to the Polyhaven library, about one per week, it is immediately added to this library in our asset browser. And with the add-on installed, we actually get early access to the assets. In some cases, that's months before they're available publicly. In the add-on settings, we can choose how often to check for updates. It defaults to daily, but adjust as you see fit. I've really come to trust the quality of the assets on Polyhaven. I reached out to them when this came out, and I can vouch that these are truly altruistic people trying to help artists. They were hesitant even to be charging for the add-on, but it is a way to support the site and continue doing what they do. So check out the add-on with the link in the description and support Polyhaven. Also, check out an up-to-date guide on using the plugin on my site, brandonsdrawings.com, and have a look around at my other resources for Blender users. Take care, enjoy the add-on, and stay creative.